scope of education. The scope of education is very comprehensive as well as very wide. The fields of education have occupied different aspects of this universe. Here, scope means the range, breadth, variety, and elasticity of subjects. It also includes opportunity of activity, operations, and application. The scope of education is limitless and very wide. Education is a process of development. It is a process of all-round development of physical, mental, moral, and spiritual capacities of an individual. It is a complete development of a man's personality. The scope of education is related to the manner, values, morals, tastes, skills, attitudes, etc. With the scope of education, many subjects are included. It draws only functional material from subjects like philosophy of education, educational sociology, educational psychology, history of education, comparative education, educational problems, educational administration and organization, teaching techniques, etc. Besides these subject matters, there are some other fields which are also included by the scope of education. New subjects are being developed in the field of education and the study has widened the scope of education. The present field of education use specialists in order to make education more progressive. Education not only preserves but also promotes culture and creates conditions for a better world order and a better civilization. It is now rightly felt that a new world of peace, freedom, justice, and safety for all can be achieved only by those who are moved by the great moral and spiritual values which true education upholds and propagates. True education is that education which shows us the way as how to live a corporate life, useful and meaningful life in the present day, rapidly changing and amazingly complex world. Human life is full of struggle. We must build our education system in a way that can solve our present day problem of this materialistic world. Education must contribute towards making our life happy, prosperous, progressive, and civilized. Aims of education. Education is a planned and purposeful activity. It is perceived as a preparation for life, that is, a process to prepare young people for the future, set them off on a path of life, provide them with knowledge of facts, and train their intellects for life's journey. Aim is the real force which directs and makes education meaningful. Unless we have a clear-cut aim of education, we shall not be able to discharge its function. We know that education is a purposeful and organized activity which deliberately tries to modify the behaviors of the educand with a specific aim in view. This is the criterion with which all educational efforts are being judged. It is only after we have fixed our aims of education for a particular stage, example primary, secondary, university, we will devise methods, means and curriculum and utilize them for attaining the desired goal. Again, among the different types of education, such as humanistic, scientific, technical, art, commercial, etc., each of them have their own aims. But as a whole, the general goal of education can be considered as man-making. Determining the aims of education is necessary for the following reasons. As we have already stated, education is a planned and organized activity. A definite aim of education gives us direction to act in a definite way. According to John Dewey, acting with an aim is all one with acting intelligently. This signifies that if there is an aim in view, we are aware what we are doing and why we are doing it. In this way, we can save our time and energy and activity becomes meaningful. Aims are necessary to assess the outcomes or results of the educative activity. We can easily review the ways and means adopted for acquiring the desired goal and can think of the possibilities of further improvement. Aim is thus a yardstick by which we can measure the success and failure of work done in school. Clear determination of educational aim can only ensure development of life in the right direction towards reaching the goal. Behind any scientific plan and program, there is a clear-cut aim and purpose. Aims are necessary for efficient school management also. It helps in proper planning of the curriculum, library, method of teaching, selection of teachers, selection of teaching aids and apparatus, system of evaluation, standard of discipline, etc., which depends on the aims of education. From the point of view of teachers and guardians, also aims are necessary because the society reviews and appreciates the work of the school in terms of its aims. In a democratic society, this assumes much greater importance. Finally, aims provide continuity and significance to education. We know that education is a continuous and dynamic process. It is a process of living through a continuous reconstruction of experiences that is unfolding new dimensions of knowledge, developing new capacities in the individual, which is not possible without having aim of education. Classification and characteristics of aims of education. By now, we have developed a fair understanding about the necessity of determining the aims in education. The necessity has led to the development of certain aims. Different educationists have put forward their views regarding aims of education. But then, there is no single aim of education which is acceptable to all. Moreover, aims are not static. They go on changing from time to time and from country to country depending on the philosophy of life, political ideologies and socio-economic condition of the country. Broadly speaking, there have emerged two important aims of education, one emphasizing the development of individuality and the other giving stress on social development, that is social and civic efficiency. The root of these two aims may be attributed to two basic philosophical ideas of individualism and collectivism. Some other specific aims are formulated on the basis of intrinsic values and universal elements. Thus, we can classify the aims of education as individual aim, social aim, democratic aim, vocational aim, moral and cultural aim. Now we will make a detailed discussion of the above mentioned aims of education. Individual aim of education. Let us first discuss the individual aim of education. Naturalism is the main school of philosophy which has contributed to the growth of the individual aim of education. Sir Percy Nunn, the chief supporter of individual aim, observed that individuality is the ideal of life and added that the scheme of education is ultimately to be valued by its success in fostering the highest degree of individual excellence. Thus, individual aim believes that the success of education depends on the development of highest potentialities of the individual. Therefore, maximum opportunities should be made available to each individual for developing their physical, moral, intellectual, and spiritual possibilities, unhindered by environment and unhampered by the society. Individual aim also believes that social development basically depends upon individual development. A fully developed individual can only bring social change and development. Now, let us examine the viewpoints of different schools of thought supporting the individual aim of education. From biological point of view, every child is a unique entity born with certain potentialities and natural endowments. The function of education is to develop them into a distinct personality. According to naturalist thinkers like Rousseau and Nunn, the central aim of education is autonomous development of the individual. Therefore, education should be planned according to nature, which would make an individual what he ought to be. The psychologists are of the opinion that education is an individual process. No two children are identical in intellectual capacity and other dispositions. Therefore, a rigid curriculum for all students is not justified. The process of education should be individualized. The spiritualists hold that the main function of education should be to lead the individual to self. The supporters of progressivism are of the view that the progress and advancement of mankind is due to the contribution of great individuals who were born at different periods of history. Therefore, the process of education should create conditions for the development of the individuality. It is also important for us to know the points of criticism raised against individual aim of education. Firstly, extreme form of individualism makes a person selfish and self-centered. Unrestricted freedom encourages indiscipline among students. Secondly, individual aim of education ignores the social cultural influence on the individual. It is considered as an essential factor in the development of human personality. Thirdly, it is not possible to construct curriculum for every individual child. It will make education very expensive. Fourthly, too much importance on individuality may lead to feeling of superiority among some individuals. They may develop immoral behavior and unhealthy attitudes. Social aim of education. Now that we know what individual aim of education is, let us discuss the social aim of education. Social aim believes that the state or society is the supreme and individual exists only for the society. Individuals cannot develop in isolation from the society. Therefore, education must always work for the welfare and progress of the society. According to this aim, the interest of the society is supreme and the position of an individual is always subordinated to the society or state. The basic philosophy of social aim is that society is the ultimate reality and individual cannot rise above the social entity. John Dewey is the chief supporter of the social aim of education, and he has elaborately discussed the social aim of education in his book Democracy in Education. He broadly outlined the aim of education as social efficiency, which implies civic efficiency or education for citizenship. According to him, every state must design education for social welfare and efficiency. A socially efficient individual will be economically self-sufficient and he will not be a parasite on society but will contribute positively towards the progress of the society. With the development of democratic ideals in the political world, Dewey's concept of social efficiency as an educational aim has gained wider support throughout the world. Now let us see why educationists have laid stress on the social aim of education. Man cannot live without a society. He develops through social context and therefore he needs to be trained and developed for social efficiency. It ensures social progress. Social efficiency must be achieved by the positive use of individual power and capacities in social occupations. Such a person is not a burden on society but contributes to its development. He also abides by moral and social standards of conduct. Democratic society requires individuals who are physically fit, intellectually bright, economically self-sufficient and morally well-equipped, who can contribute to social progress. It is believed that this can be achieved through social aim of education. Gandhiji, the father of basic education in India, he also emphasized on the social aim of education. He formulated the scheme of basic education with the objective of making man a better citizen and molding him in accordance with the needs of the community. After developing a fair understanding regarding social aim of education, now it is necessary for us to know on what grounds the social aim of education has been criticized. Firstly, social aim of education may develop the sense of dictatorship or authoritarianism of the state towards education. In such a state, individuals may not find suitable scope for development. Secondly, social aim in its extreme form can never be accepted as it reduces the individual to a mere non-entity. Thirdly, the extreme notion of all-powerful state or society is that it ignores legitimate needs, desires and interests of the individual and suppresses his creative power. Fourthly, the concept of social aim, if understood narrowly, may prove harmful for a democratic country like India. The political groups in power may interpret it in terms of its own ideology and education may become an instrument of struggle for political power. Finally, it does not give any importance to individual development of a person and his inherent qualities.